Hello friends, I am Vidya Patil, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering in Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, Yatra. Today, we are going to learn the belt and chain drives. In this session, we are going to see the belt drives, flat and V-belts, geometric relationship, analysis of belt tension, and condition for maximum power. And related to that, one small example. First, we see the belt drives. There are two types of drives, rigid drive and flexible drive. Gear drives are called as rigid drives or non-flexible drives. And belt drives, chain drives, and rope drives are called flexible drives. Gear drives called rigid drives because there is a direct contact between the driving and driven shaft through the gears. But in flexible drives, there is an intermediate link such as belt, rope or chain between the driving and driven shaft. Since this link is flexible and the drive is called flexible drives. In gear drives, the rotary motion of the driving shaft is directly converted into rotary motion of the driven shaft by means of pinion and gears. But in flexible drives, the rotary motion of the driving shaft is first converted into translatory motion of the belt or chain and then again converted into rotary motion of the driven shaft. Thus, a flexible element is superimposed between the driving and driven element. There are some advantages of flexible drives over the rigid drives, such as flexible drives transmit power over a comparatively long distances due to an intermediate link between driving and driven shaft. The intermediate link is long and flexible. It absorbs shock and loads and damp vibrations also. Flexible drives provide considerable flexibility in the location of driving and driven shaft. Flexible drives are cheap compared to gear drives, hence, but there are some disadvantages also for these flexible drives, such as they occupy more space and the velocity ratio is relatively small. In general, the velocity ratio is also not constant for these drives. Belt drives are used to transmit the power between the two shafts by means of a friction. The belt drive consists mainly three elements. First is a driving and driven pulleys and endless belt, which envelops them. Belt drives offer the advantages over the other types of drives. First advantage is that the belt drive can transmit power over considerable distances between the axis of the driving and driven shafts. Second, the operation is smooth and silent. The belt drive transmit only definite load. If this definite load exceeds, which will cause the belt to slip over the pulley, and they have the ability to absorb the shocks and damp vibration. Also, the design is very simple and have low initial cost. But there is some disadvantages of belt drives over other types of drives. First disadvantage is that belt drives have large dimensions and occupy more space. Also, the velocity ratio is not a constant due to the belt slip. And also, heavy impose the heavy loads on the shaft and bearings. There is considerable loss of power resulting in low efficiency, and belt drive have comparatively short service life. These belt drives are mainly used in electric motors, automobiles, machine tools, and conveyors. Depending upon the shape of the cross section, belts are classified as flat belts and V belts. Here, the two figures are shown. First figure shows the flat belts and second for the V belt. The flat belts have narrow rectangular cross section, while V belts have trapezoidal cross section. Flat belts are used in belt conveyors, baking machinery, bricks and clay machinery, saw machinery, textile machinery, line shaft and bucket elevators. And V belts are very popular, and they are used in electric motor, is used as a prime movers to drive compressor pumps, fans, positive displacement pumps, machine tools, and also popular in automobiles to drive accessories of petrol and diesel engine. The velocity ratio of flat belt is up to 4:1, and the velocity ratio of V belt is up to 7:1. The flat belts offer the advantages over the V belts. There are various advantages. First is that they are relatively cheap and easy to maintain. Also, flat belt drive can be used as a clutch by making the simple provision of shifting the belt from tight to loose pulley and vice versa. The different velocity ratios can be obtained by using stepped pulleys, where the belt is shifted from one step to another, having different diameters. Flat belts can be used in light duty and abrasive atmosphere and required no closed casing. The design of flat belt drive is simple and inexpensive. They can be used for long center distances, even up to 15 meter, and the efficiency of the flat belt drive is more than V belt drive. The flat belt offers some disadvantages over the V belts. That is, the power transmission capacity of flat belt drive is low. The velocity ratio of the flat belt drive is lower than V belt drive. The flat belt drives have large dimensions and occupy more space compared to V belt drives, and flat belts generate more noise than V belts. In general, flat belt drives are horizontal and not vertical. Same as compared with flat belts, V belts offer the following advantages. That means the force of friction between the surfaces of the belt and V-grooved pulley is high due to wedge action, and this wedging action permits a smaller arc of contact, increases the pulling capacity of the belt, and consequently results in increasing power transmitting capacity. V-belts have short center distance, which results in compact construction. They permit high speed reduction, even up 7:1. Flat belts are hinged while V belts are endless, which results in smooth and quiet operation even at high operating speeds. The drive is positive because the slip is negligible due to wedge action, and V belt drive can operate in any position even when the belt is vertical. But there are some disadvantages also of V-belt drive over a flat belt drive. First, the ratio of the cross-section height to pulley diameter is large in case of V-belt. This increases bending stresses in the belt cross-section and adversely affects the durability. The efficiency of V-belt is lower than that of the flat belt, and the creep is also higher. The construction of V-grooved pulleys is complicated and costlier compared with pulleys of the flat belt drive. Now we see the belt materials. The belt material for the flat belts and V-belts having some properties, like the belt material should have high coefficient of friction with the pulleys. The belt material should have high tensile strength withstand belt tensions, have high wear resistance. The belt material should have high flexibility and low rigidity in bending in order to avoid the bending stresses while passing over the pulley. Generally, the belts are made of leather, canvas, rubber or rubberized fabric and synthetic materials. Generally, fabric rubber belts are widely used in engineering industries because they have some important advantages, like they have high load carrying capacity, they have long service life, and they can operate at high operating speeds of up to 300 meters per second. But fabric rubber belts have some disadvantages, like they cannot operate on a small diameter pulleys, and they are subjected to distribution in environment of mineral oil, gasoline, and alkalis. Now we see the geometric relationship. There are two types of belt construction. First is a open belt drive and second is a cross belt drive. In first figure, we see the open belt drive. In open belt drive is a belt drive in which the belt proceeds from the top of one pulley to the top of another without crossing. In an open belt drive, both driving and driven pulleys rotate in same direction. In open belt drives, when the center distances is more, the belt whips, that is, vibrates in a direction perpendicular to the direction of motion. When the center distance is small, the belt slip increases, and both these factors limits the use of open belt drive. In this figure, in open belt drive, there are some dimensions of the open belt drives are given. First is alpha S. Alpha S is the wrap angle for the small pulley. That is alpha S. This is the wrap angle for the small pulley. And alpha B is the wrap angle for the large pulley. The diameter of the large pulley is capital T and diameter of the small pulley is small d. And C is the center distance between these two pulleys. The length of this belt is calculated by the formula L is equal to 2C plus pi capital D plus d divided by 2 plus capital D minus d in bracket square divided by 4C. Same as in crossed belt drive. In crossed belt drive, a belt drive in which the belt proceeds from the top of one pulley to the bottom of another pulley. Bottom of another pulley and crossed over itself. Again, this crossed belt drive, the angle of wrap is also more. Therefore, power transmitting capacity of crossed belt drive is more than that of an open belt drive. Okay, in crossed belt drive, the belt rubs against itself while crossing. Also, the belt has to bend in two different planes. These two factors increase the wear and reduce the life of the belt. Here we see the another formula to calculate the length of the cross belt, that is L is equal to 2C plus pi capital D plus D divided by 2 plus capital D plus D bracket square divided by 4C. Here we see this angle is more than cross belt drive. Next. Now we see the analysis of belt tension. Here in this figure we see the forces on the flat belt. Here P1 and P2, these are the two tensions at tight side and loose side. This is the tight side of the belt P1 and P2 is the at loose side. We see that here we take the belt, this belt portion. Here three types of forces acting. First force tension P at tension P at loose side and P plus dP, and again this is dN at frictional and reaction between the belt surface and the pulley. Here P1 is the belt tension in the tight side and P2 is the belt tension in loose side. M is the mass of the 1 meter length of the belt in kg per meter and V is the velocity, belt velocity in meter per second. F is the coefficient of friction and alpha is the angle of wrap of the belt in radians. The tension, an element of the belt subtending an angle d theta, is an equilibrium under the action of the following forces, that is tension P and P plus dP on the loose and tight sides respectively. Second force, that is normal reaction between the surfaces of the belt and pulley, and the frictional force F into dN at the interface. And third is the centrifugal force which is acting radially outward direction. The expression for the calculating the centrifugal force is given as centrifugal force is equal to mass into acceleration. Okay, and the mass is calculated by the formula, that is m into r d theta, and centripetal acceleration is given by F is equal to v square divided by r. From this above three equation, we calculated the centrifugal force as m r d theta v square divided by r is equal to m v square d theta. Now we see the condition for maximum power. Condition for maximum power, for that we first consider at initial condition, that is belt is an initial tension, that is PI, in order to transmit power, and the initial tension is depends upon the length of the belt, the elasticity of belt material, the geometry of pulleys and the center distance between the two pulleys. And there are some assumptions are also given. First assumption is that the length of the belt is constant. Second assumption, the belt has linear elasticity. When the driving pulley begins, in these assumptions are in initial condition. But when the pulleys are in rotated and begins to rotate, the elongation of the tight side is proportional to P1 minus PI, that is at tension at tight side minus initial tension, while the contraction on the loose side is proportional to PI minus P2, that means tension at initial tension minus tension at loose side. For constant belt length, the elongation on the tight side is equal to the contraction on the loose side, and therefore P1 minus PI is equal to PI minus P2. We calculated in terms of PI, that is 1 upon 2 P1 plus P2. In initial and in the analysis of forces, we calculated this term as P1 minus mv square divided by P2 minus mv square is equal to e raised to f alpha. We put in terms of, we again this calculated in terms of P2 minus mv square divided by P1 minus mv square. We rearrange this term and 1 upon e raised to f alpha. Again, we do the inverse of this. We got P1 plus P2 minus 2 mv square divided by P2 minus P1 is equal to e raised to minus f alpha plus 1 divided by e raised to minus f alpha minus 1. Substituting this PI value, PI is equal to 1 upon 2 P1 plus P2 into this above equation, we got the values of power, that is P1 plus P2 into V. And again, by differentiating power with respect to velocity and equating the result to zero, we got the optimum velocity of the belt for maximum power transmission. It's given by V is equal to under root Pi divided by 3m. This is condition for maximum power. Now we see one small example related to these terms. I read the example first. The layout of the leather belt drive transmitting 15 kW of power as shown in figure. The center distance between the pulleys is twice the diameter of the bigger pulley, and the belt should operate at a velocity of 20 meter per second approximately, and the stresses in the belt should not exceed 2.25 Newton per mm square. The density of the leather is 90.95 and the coefficient of friction is 0.35. The thickness of the belt is 5 mm. We have to calculate the diameter of pulleys, the length and width of the belt, and the belt tension. Here the diagram is given. The small d, small pulley diameter is a small d. Gear diameter or bigger pulley having capital D diameter. The N1 is 1440 rpm and N2 that is 480 rpm, and the center distance is 2d. Now we first calculate, first in solution we see the given data. Here power is given, kilowatt is equal to 15, velocity is given 20 meter per second, center distance C is equal to 2d, thickness of the belt is 5 mm, then rho 0.95, that is density of the leather, sigma that is stresses 2.25 Newton per mm square, and F that is 0.35, coefficient of friction is 0.35. In first step we are going to calculate the diameter of the pulleys. For that, first we know the velocity of the belt, that is V is equal to 20 meter per second. By using this formula we calculate the diameter, that is small d, diameter of the small pulley, that is velocity V is equal to pi dn upon 60 into 1000. We convert in the term of diameter, that is 60 into 1000 into velocity divided by pi n is equal to putting this value we got the diameter of the small pulley, that is 265.26 mm, we taken as 270 mm. Okay, the diameter of the pulleys are d is equal to 270 mm. Now we calculate the diameter for the bigger pulley. We know the formula for that. D1 upon D2 is equal to N2 upon N1. By using this relation, we calculate the diameter of the bigger pulley, that is 810 mm. Okay. Now in second step, we calculate the belt length. To calculate the belt length, first we have to calculate the center distance between these two pulleys. And center distance C is equal to 2D. So C is equal to 1620 mm. Okay. Now we have the formula. You already seen the formula for the length, calculating the length of the open belt, that is L is equal to open belt drive, that is L is equal to 2C pi D plus D divided by 2 plus D minus D bracket square divided by 4C. Putting all this value, we got length 4981.46 mm. Okay. Next, in third step, we are going to calculate the belt width and belt tensions. Okay. For that, in last slide, we see that we calculated here the velocity is there given, but now by considering the value of small d diameter, that is 270 mm, we again the calculate the correct belt velocity, that is V is equal to, by using formula, V is equal to pi dN upon 60 into 1000. Putting these values, we got the velocity, correct velocity, that is 20.36 meter per second. Okay, and next, for open belt drive, the formula for calculating the angle of strap, that is 1 alpha s is equal to 180 minus 2 sine inverse diameter capital D minus D divided by 2c. We got the alpha s in terms of radian, that is 2.81 radian. In problem, they are given the density of the leather as 0.95 gram per cubic centimeter. Okay, so we convert these values first. The volume of 1 meter belt in cubic centimeter is given by, first we calculate volume, length into width into thickness. Length 1 meter for 1 meter belt, so 100, width b by 10 and thickness 5 by 10. But where the b is in width in mm, so mass m is equal to for 9.95 into 100 b by 10, 5 by 10. So we calculate m in terms of b, width, that is 4.75 into 10 raised to minus 3 kg per meter. Now we calculate mv square and e raised to f alpha. To put these values in this equation, in analysis of this equation, we got in analysis of belt tension, we got P1 minus mv square divided by P2 minus mv square is equal to e raised to f alpha. Putting this mv square value and e raised to f alpha value in this equation, we got P1 minus 2.67 P2 plus 3.29 B, that is width, is equal to 0. And for the maximum stresses, the belt is given as 2.25 Newton per mm square in problem. So we calculate first sigma is equal to maximum tension divided by area of cross section of the belt. And maximum tension is always at the tight side of the belt. So maximum tension is equal to P1 and area of cross section of the belt, that is A. So P1 is equal to, in terms of P1, is equal to sigma into A. So put this value of sigma 2.25, which is given in problem, and area 5B. So we calculate P1 in terms of width, that is B. That is equation 2. And again, we know the power transmission equation, that is P1 minus P2 into V. Power P is equal to P1 minus P2 into V 1000 is rearranged in terms of P1 minus P2 1000, that is kilowatt power divided by V, that is 1000 15 power divided by velocity 20.36. This is correct velocity after calculating the diameter of the pulleys, and we got P1 minus P2 736.74 Newton. Equation 3. Solving this equation number 1, 2 and 3 simultaneously, we got the values of P1, P2 and width of the belt. That is, width of the belt V is equal to 1.27.02 mm or 130 mm, and P1 is equal to 1428.98 Newton and P2 is equal to 692.26 Newton. Okay. Thank you.